Why are so many people wasting money not using these Sol-Ark time-of-use settings? Don't be one of them. Hey everyone, Solar Jojo here. Are you confused by Sol-Ark's time-of-use settings? It's so confusing, like why is it so confusing? In this video, I'm going to show you how to save a ton of money by updating your Sol-Ark time-of-use settings. Okay, what are time-of-use rates? Those are agreements with your utility to pay for electricity at a different price depending on the time of day. That means that prices are sometimes high when there's peak demand, like in the late afternoon, or prices are really low, like in the middle of the night. Over 60% of US households have access to time of use rates with your utility, but less than 10% of people are actually using them. So look at your electricity bill and look for something like rate or rate schedule or service plan, and look for a code or a name to figure out what rate schedule that you're currently on. Then go on your utility website and try to figure out how to switch to a time of use plan. And you can do some math to see if you can save money by switching to this plan. And here's the trick. If you have a smart inverter, like a Sol-Ark, you can update the settings to take advantage of these time of use rates, where you could save even more money than what you're saving with solar and batteries. I sat down for hours, I read all the manuals, I read all the documentation, I figured out the best way you can set up these time of use settings. But don't worry, in this video, I'll walk you through all the steps.
Okay, so this is the main dashboard for your Sol-Ark inverter. And there's really two ways to program your inverter and program the energy management system, EMS. You could do it on the very front cover of the inverter by tapping the buttons and tapping through the screens, or you could go into the web browser interface where you have more visibility and more control over the systems. I prefer this browser setting, but you could do all the things that I'm saying by tapping on the front screen of the inverter. So if you have some issues with trying to get your browser set up or your account set up with my Sol-Ark, then you could still do it on the front of the inverter. If you'd like to learn more about how to set up the solarkcloud.com account, I recommend just going to the Sol-Ark website and figuring out how to do that there. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised at how much easier it is to program things from your laptop inside your house rather than going to the inverter every time. So I've set up time of use settings on a few different projects. Each project's a little bit different. Sometimes I've had some customers that have DC coupled solar through the Sol-Ark. Sometimes it's AC coupled outside of the system. And sometimes it's whole home backup. And sometimes it's just partial load backup. So there are a few different settings, how to configure for those different setups. This video, I'm not going to cover those, but I may touch on them a little bit. Okay, so this is the first dashboard that you'll see when you log into my Sol-Ark, the solarkcloud.com. In this example, this is a friend's site. What you'll see is you only see one system available. And the best thing to do is first, you'll see that one is connected, one is normal. If you just click on the name, you'll get up some basic details about how the system is running. What you're going to do is scroll down here to see the energy generation. This is a good place to see if your system is functioning properly. So, as I mentioned in the early part of the video, having solar and batteries can really save you money because you're not using as much energy from the utility. But the way that you charge and discharge the battery can be done in many different ways. So in this video, I'm helping you find ways to optimize as much money as you can save from the utility. And the goal is to use the least amount of energy from the utility and preferably use the least amount during the times that it's most expensive. And if you have to pull some extra energy from the utility when the cost is really cheap, then all the benefits go to you. So in this example, this is just yesterday. You can see that it took almost all day for the batteries to charge up from solar, even though it was a cloudy day. And then in the afternoon, the load started kicking on because I have time of use set up here. And the loads really kicked on. This is probably air conditioning. And if you look, I'm going to take some things off. So this is only looking at the grid. The goal here was energy is most expensive from 5 p.m. to I think 11 p.m. And the goal here is to use no energy ever, as much as possible, during the most expensive times. The least expensive times are in the middle of the night, so using energy here is fine. We even have it set up where it can use energy during the day. But the goal is to reduce energy consumption from the utility at this time. And this is doing a really good job at that. So we are lucky that we were able to charge up the batteries. It looked like it got down to about 30% SOC. We just barely were able to get to, oh, not even 100 SOC, 100%. Got to about 93%. But it was enough energy from the solar put into the batteries to cover the, those night loads. Now, there might be other days where this didn't go so well. The previous day, we can show what happened here. So let's turn these off and these off. And you can see what happened is we got the batteries fully charged, and they sat fully charged for a long time. And right at 3 p.m., we started to discharge the batteries to minimize the amount of energy used during that peak period. So this is when energy is most expensive from the utility. So you do not want to import power. And we got down to 30% SOC, and this system is set up where when it gets to 30% SOC, then the battery will stop discharging. So we got all the way to 8 p.m. by not using any energy. But then by that point, the batteries were nearly depleted and we had to use some grid energy. So this will happen, but at least we're minimizing the amount of energy we're pulling from the grid. And usually we're using less power later in the evening anyways. It's a bit cooler. We're not running cooking and dishwashers and everything. Okay, now let's go to the area where we can adjust the time of use settings. And to do that is from the main dashboard. This is the first page you'll see. You'll come over here, you'll click on equipment. You'll click on inverter. This is a little buried, so it took a little while to find this. Then you click on the three dots over here on the right for that particular site. And we're gonna do parameters settings. And once we're in there, these are all the same settings that you could adjust on the front of the inverter. Now the battery settings, we've already set that up. That's pretty self-explanatory. There's a whole different video of discussing how to do that properly for lithium-ion batteries, so I'm going to skip that today. The main area that we're going to focus on is the system work mode. So the work mode is very important, and this is something you need to figure out on based on how your system is set up. When you're doing a whole home backup, it makes sense to have limit power to load. And understanding these three settings is very important. The other option here is solar cell. We want to be able to sell solar. We want to be able to export solar power to the grid if we need to. And then there's also zero net export as an option here. Some of the max solar power settings. The energy pattern is, do you want to charge up the batteries or cover the loads? In this scenario, we're matching battery first. Okay, time of use. Let's talk about this. You want to toggle the time of use on. Once that's on, you'll have a few different settings. You'll have the days of the week of when you want to be running this time of use. Here, I just set up every day. So this one's tricky. So first, let me just talk about how there's six time slots, time one through six. You need to use all of them. You can't have any blank ones. I have this one set up as 1 in the morning, 9, 3 p.m., 4 p.m., 5 p.m., and 11 p.m. It's listed in Army time. So now that I have those there, next you'll have charge and sell. On this site, I actually have nothing checked because I basically have it being only charging the batteries from solar. So solar power will always go to the batteries in the way I have it set up here, and the batteries will not charge from the grid. I am actually going to change that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to allow the batteries to charge late at night, in the middle of the night, because the energy is cheap. And for that site, this is acceptable. So I'm actually going to say that it can charge at time six and time one. So time one is 1 in the morning to 9 a.m. That's when energy is very cheap. times 6 is, yeah, just 11 to 1. So that's a change that I'm going to do for this site. I'm not going to select sell because this is a whole home backup, and I don't need to have that checked to cover other loads. And also, there's no benefit of selling energy at a particular time to the utility because they don't give you any benefit. So for DTE, they don't pay you a large amount of money per kilowatt hour to discharge and export during the peak use time. So the benefit here is to just zero out the bill at the peak use times. So I'm not going to have anything selected on sell. It's also really important to never have charge and sell selected on the same time zone. You never want to do that because it'll make the battery do really weird things. The second thing is, the really weird part about the time of use is in each of these time zones, you're telling the battery where it should be. So let's just look at here. Let's jump to time zone 5. So it's time zone 5 here. You're saying at 5 p.m., you can discharge as much as 10 kilowatts, and you need to get the battery to 30% SOC. Now, because I'm saying you don't want to sell to the grid, it's not just going to dump 10 kilowatts into the grid. If it was checked, it might do that. But instead, what it's going to do is it's going to say, if there's any loads that are under 10 kilowatts, I'm going to cover them until I reach 30% SOC. And once I reach 30% SOC, I'm going to stop. Then it moves on to the next time zone number 6. And at 11 p.m., it says you can discharge at 500 watts up to SOC 50%. So since the battery is already lower, the only way it could go up to 50% is if it charges. There's no sunlight at that time. So in the current setup, it kind of just sits at 30%. But now that I have this checked up here, it's going to charge from the grid up to 50%. And that'll give a little bit of a boost for the batteries. This isn't really needed in summertime, but this is really helpful to do in wintertime. So you may want to come in and adjust these things every once in a while to improve the performance of your system. Okay, so now it's going to charge really slowly up to 50%. It might not even make it overnight because it's only 500 watts. And then it'll go up to 75% at when time slot 1 at 500 watts. And then at 9 a.m., because I don't have charge selected here, 9 a.m., it's just going to rest at wherever it is. And solar will be allowed to charge the batteries and get it up to 100%. So time zone 2, 3, 4, they're basically kind of like in a bypass mode. So that's how I have this site set up for time of use. Every project is a bit different. Unfortunately, this is kind of a trial and error. I've been tweaking these settings for friends and customers many times to see what kind of performance we get. We make some settings, we come back a few days later and see what happens.
So here's the bottom line. Setting up your smart inverter and setting up the time of use settings correctly can save you a ton of money on your energy bills. This is without adding any new equipment. Most systems aren't set up correctly out of the box. You need to understand your utility bill and how your time of use settings work, and then you need to fine tune your inverter to match your utility schedule. So let's look at an example. This is a real before and after from one project. It's the same home, it's the same solar equipment. All I did was fine tune the time of use settings. We cut the peak usage down to 0. At the peak usage time, they're pulling no energy from the grid. This is good. This means that they're not paying too much for electricity. Whenever they're pulling from the grid, it's usually at nighttime when energy is the cheapest. Doing just this change saved them over $80 per month, and that could be almost $1,000 in a year. And this is with simply reprogramming the inverter. It's not adding any equipment, not installing anything else. It's simply just making setting changes on the inverter. Okay, here's two quick takeaways. Number one, don't assume that your installer set up your settings correctly in your inverter. Always check your inverter settings, check that time of use, hours and times are set up correctly. Number two, test, monitor, and tweak. This isn't a set it and forget it kind of thing. What you do in the summertime is going to be different than what you do in the wintertime. All right, if this video helped you, hit like below. Also, if you'd like to subscribe for more videos about solar and batteries, please do hit the subscribe button below. I gotta clean up the bounce house. The bounce house out there. We gotta go clean it up. It was a hit. The bounce house was a hit.